Anybody who can be responsible for another life can probably be responsible with your apartment.
There are fewer rental options available if you're looking to live with your pets. And now the City of Vancouver's Renters Advisory Committee wants to change that.
Having pets has really kept me tethered and grounded and really been a positive mental and physical sort of outlet for me.
Vancouver City Councillors Pete Fry and Jean Swanson are putting forward a motion on behalf of the Renters Advisory Committee asking the mayor to push the province to end the no pets clause in rental contracts.
The Ontario RTA has specifically prohibited people from landlords from having no pet clauses, and it's been okay, and it still allows remedies, so you know you can still go after your tenant if they do damages because of their pet.
According to the BC Residential Tenancy Branch, landlords have the right to prohibit pets and the right to restrict the size, kind, and number of animals.
What's missing in the current no pet clauses in the RTA, or the allowance of a no pet through the RTA, is a lack of real evidence-based decision-making here.
In an email to City News, the CEO of Landlord BC said he does not have any comment on the motion at this time. But John Stovell with Reliance Properties says he opposes it, even though some of the buildings he manages are pet-friendly.
A lot of pet owners are more mature and established and are great tenants, but there's also a lot of pet owners who are irresponsible with their pets. So making this blanket policy, I think, is ill-advised. Like, a lot of landlords will say no pets as a standard policy, but if you talk to them, they'll sometimes allow a pet. They just want that opportunity to say, okay, how big is the dog? How old is it? What do you do with it during the day?
According to apartment hunting website PadMapper, there are more than 2,700 rentals available in Vancouver. Of those, just over 200 specify that they allow cats and dogs.
You don't have a right to live anywhere just because you have a pet. And then also, pets can infringe on the rights of others.
The BC SPCA and the Vancouver Orphan Kitten Rescue Association are in favor of the motion, explaining that no pet policies often lead to surrendered animals.
Each year, approximately one quarter of the dogs and cats coming into our custody and care, the animal owner references the fact that are experiencing trouble finding pet-friendly housing.
We get cats back that have been adopted through VOCRA and they can't find suitable housing. And then we get a lot of people calling in and asking if we'll take their cats because they cannot find suitable housing.
Miranda Fatour, City News.